Hi, in this video we will learn about the flip matrix component, how it works. Here I have this component here, the curve component, and inside there are three circles. So I will use divide curves here in division, divide curve, and I will choose 8 for the count of the divisions here. So here I have 3 sublists, and Grasshopper created 3 sublists because these are independent curves. So divide curve operates separately on each of them, on each one of them, so it creates a list for the points of this circle and another list for the points coming out from this circle. So these are 3 separate lists, and they don't communicate with each other. They are, you can imagine them even placed next to each other and like separate lists. And now I will hide the initial circles. I will bring in the interpolate curve, plug the points to the vertices input, and I will use a boolean toggle to set periodic to true to close the curve. So, and the result here is a list of 3 sublists. Like here we have 3 sublists, and so each curve coming out from each sublist will have its own lists here. But if I bring a flip matrix component and plug the points to its input, and then plug the output to vertices, we will have a different results. I will set periodic to false. So what happened here? Actually, we can look at the data structure. Compared to this one. Before, we had 3 sublists. Now I put them here next to each other, so we can consider these as 3 columns, and we had 8 rows. Flipping the matrix is like taking all of these and rotate them 90 degrees to have something like this. And now we create new sublists like this. So we take the first element from the first column with the first element of the second column and the first element of the third, like this, and we create a sublist from them, like we did here. So the first element with the first element with the first element. And we continue. As you can see, the new number of columns equals the old number of rows. Now we have 8 columns. And the new number of rows equals the old number of columns, 3 rows, as you can see here. So now, when we plug and interpolate, we will have, of course, 8 sublists of 8 curves. Now, just for fun, and it got nothing to do with the flip matrix thing, I will add the boundary surface to the initial curves. And for these, I will connect a pipe. The value, let's say, of 1, maybe. Yeah, and that's it for this tutorial. I hope you learned something, and if you like it, please press the like button and subscribe to the channel. And see you in the next video. Thank you.